All right, what's going on, everyone? Welcome back. Another episode, pretty excited. It's been a little while between gigs, but we've come up with just about the only thing we can do at the moment, and that's get out in the boat. So we've got a bit of a special guest appearance this trip. We got Justin from Trip in a Van. So we just come up here at the moment to Noosa Caravan Park, and we brought him up a boat. We brought him up the new MAKO Craft 630. I've got the MAKO Craft 490 behind my boat. Timmy from MAKO Craft is here as well. And I brought my mate along, Alex, because he knows how to fish a little bit better than me, which is not very impressive, to be honest. But look, we're just going to gear up here. We've got all the boats on the back. We're going to head straight up to Harvey Bay, and basically we're going to spend a couple nights out exploring the west coast of Fraser and staying on the boats, because unfortunately there's still no camping. But something a little bit different for us. I can't wait. Let's get into it. Okay, so as you guys all know, COVID has been one massive pain in the ass. All national parks are closed, and unfortunately we are unable to camp on Fraser Island. But we are dying to get out, so we've come up with a bit of a plan. We've got the whole crew. We're heading up to a privately owned caravan park where we'll be camping, just us. The park's not open to the public. From there, we're gonna chuck the boats in the drink, run over to Fraser Island and spend a couple of nights fishing and living out of the boats. It's something I've always wanted to do. Can't wait, let's have a crack.
Quick little stop, just back from the caravan park here. There's a massive big BP, Food Works, there's a bottle shop, just about everything you can need. Chemist, for those who need to buy seasick tablets. So we're just gonna load up the Eskies. Couple last minute supplies. I just grabbed a little bit of stock and some gravy for the roast tonight. We'll probably get some firewood from here as well. Then we'll head into camp, set up, do the final pack of the boats, and probably start putting all our gear together, I reckon.
Spool up.
Spool her up. All right, so we've just pulled up at Fraser Coast RV Park. What a cracking little spot now. Obviously, it's not quite open back up yet, but because this is work, we're actually the only people here, and we're gonna have our own private little camp. So she's pretty excited to have some visitors again, which is pretty cool. So we're gonna give you a quick walk around the park. They've got some pretty cool little accommodation ideas here. So I'm excited to see it. I've never actually been here. Justin's told me all about it. So we will, give you a quick walk around the park, and then we'll get this fire going. Camp oven for dinner. Yeah, baby. What a cracking little spot. So we've just pulled up. They call this the bush kitchen. There's one hell of a little setup over there. She's already left just a massive pile. So we're gonna have a little bonfire, get this camp oven ready, and then we'll do this quick little walk around. How bloody cool is this place, especially if it's going to absolutely pour rain. We've got the table, microwave, fridge, all the gear you could ever want, and a nice little stove set up over here as well. It's pretty bloody cool, I'll be honest.
I don't know how this happened, but I get asked to come along on a trip, and then I get stuck with dinner duties. So, I don't mind, we'll give it a run, but at least they can't blame me if I stuff it up because I didn't know, eh? Anyway, let's go. I've got my camp oven over here. What I run, it's a good bit of info for you. It's called a Hillbilly Camp Oven Kit, and it's got everything in it. I'll show you it later. But what we're gonna do is just do a pork roast that Maddie's brought along and a heap of veggies. So, I've got that camp oven heating up over there. I'll do my best to get a bit of crack on going. We'll we'll see how we go. So I'll put that in first, I'll cut up the veggies, we'll let that roll for about an hour, and then I'll chuck the veggies in after. Pour a bit of stock in the bottom, get it stewing around. I reckon it should go right, eh?
Oh, you are joking.
Look down here.
You
proper crackle.
Hang on, listen.
Jeez, you've done all right.
Giddy up. All right, now have a look. If you look in here, see there's a ring in top? It's like a stainless veggie ring. You can pull it out.
Oh, that's awesome. That is shit hot.
Anyway, ring lives in top. Veggies go on top. Chuck them in, mate. Just tip them on.
How many are going to end up in the dirt, Matty?
None.
Get in there, mate. Look at that.
What do you reckon, Matty?
He can come again.
Next time, the invoice goes to Explore 4x4.
Well, it doesn't get any better than this. We're back out camping. Roast on the camp oven. Justin's outdone himself. A couple of cold Larrys, bit of crackle. This is living, Barry. Just doing the final little packs. Obviously I just pulled the Wako out of the truck for food, so it's all cold. Timmy's got two batteries set up in the 630 here, so that'll keep it running. We've just stocked up with ice, we just loaded up with bait. We're full to the brim, but hopefully we'll get this in and we'll get these boats in the water.
Today's going to be some good weather. A little bit of rain in the morning, but that's all right. We'll be catching fish by then, so happy about that. Good to be out there.
Finally, getting in the water. Got my winch bitch back there sorting it out.
Going in, mate. Hopefully I don't sink the trailer or kick it too far, eh?
Here we go.
Moonbanks, have a look at this spot, just this beautiful little island. The water is ridiculous. What do you reckon, boys?
Oh, how good is this going, mate?
Brody Moss eating hard out.
We're just coming into Wathumba Creek, been a couple of hour run, been trolling along the way, and we're a little bit late, so the tide's a little bit low, so we're just sneaking across this sandbar, but it's looking pretty promising. There's some big flatties kicking around in here. So if we can make it in, we'll drop the pots, then throw some lures around, see if we can't catch some dinner, eh?
Well, we had just about bugger all luck out there except for the cracking fish that Alex dropped, but we won't mention that anymore. He's starting to get a little bit upset.
No!
No! That was good! No!
We've just come into Wathumba Creek here, which is up on the north west side of Fraser Island. Justin's had a flick by the sounds of it. He's picked up one or two flatties, which just might be lunch. We might have to cook them up shortly. So we'll have a bit of a flick here, see if we can't get a few more flatties for a bit of a feed. And then as this tide comes up, this place absolutely comes alive. It's bloody absolutely gorgeous. So
We'll wait for the tide to come up because we're not going anywhere.
Flatty, he'd go 40 centimetres. This is that crossfire, look at that. I've been using them in the Noosa River. They're just like a little surface minnow, and they are sick on the flathead. They actually take them, like, off the surface. It's a killer. Yes, first fish for the trip. Giddy up.
All right, so we just pulled into the creek there. Had a flick for flatties. Justin mentioned our one. We had a little bit of grub. We had some ham salad wraps on the boat. We just thought we'd come out now. We're gonna drop, we got four pots, so we're gonna just cut up a bit of mullet, chuck it in the pots, drop them out. And then we're gonna head back out, see if we can get a goddamn fish. Zero puffed ups. She's pretty quiet. But that's alright. Good day on the water is better than a bad day at work. No, other way around. Bad day on the water is better than a good day at work. I literally just clicked it over. I just put it out. Trawl in the second, all you bastard. The second I clicked it, bang, I was on.
That's what we're here
Didn't
for.
Didn't even have it out the back yet.
That is what we're here for.
Get that, I reckon, get that other rod.
Tuna? Oh, you foul hooked a shark.
You're kidding. No way.
Makes sense now.
Now it makes sense. Foul hooked a little shark.
Oh, he's not going anywhere.
What is it? Oh,
oh no!
No!
Stop it!
Let go!
Little Mako.
Oh, Timmy! It's a little Mako and he just bit your Mako craft sink. Wait, let go. Oh, boy, he caught this beautiful little fella. I said I literally clicked the drag in. Alright, grab the pliers and we'll let this poor bugger go. Sorry about the seat there, Timmy. You're gonna need a little bit of upholstery work. Lovely day for it.
Someone's got to be out here.
We're still on the tuna. The bastards keep bloody getting away from us. But yeah, I think the other boys in the 6:30 might be having, well, nowhere near as much fun as us.
Nah.
Yeah!
Yeah, I'm on.
Oh god. I need to go over here. Oh. Come on, mate.
Come on.
He's coming up slowly. Keep it going, keep it going.
Keep it.
That is a good size tuna.
That is what we're here for.
You beauty. Oh,
freight train.
If you're not a fisherman, you might not know this, but if you catch a tuna, you basically have to bleed them as quick as you can so that the eating is still good. Now, we had a little friend, or not so little friend, come up and visit us. So we cut that pretty short, ran a little bit further up the coastline and got back to fishing. Alright, so me and Alex have just come to a small realisation that we didn't bring a gazebo, we didn't bring a tarp, and this rain is well and truly set in. So the only cover we have is in the 6:30. We're not allowed to camp on the island because you're not allowed to camp yet. So could be an interesting night.
Big spoon, little spoon.
Let's see how we go. Idiots.
Goddamn son of a bitch.
Alright, well, we're going to leave the pots in overnight. Hopefully, with a bit of luck, we might get a little bit of crab in the morning. Something for lunch tomorrow.
Crab sangers.
Crab sangers. Cool. Looks so badass.
Alright, well, we've come in after what I would call a pretty average day fishing. We're all absolutely soaked to the bone, except for the blokes that are in the dry boat. We do have the big tuna, but it's just too dark. We've got to sleep on the boat tonight because of COVID. We're not allowed on the beach. So we've got the snags on the go. We're going to have a few cold beers. Then we're going to try and set swaggers up on the boat, which will be bloody interesting. And then hopefully tomorrow lunchtime we'll pull up somewhere in a bit of sunshine, not rain, and we'll cook up some fish. Happy days.
It actually poured down today, absolutely bucketed. So because the swag bags have held so much water, my pillow is completely drenched because it wasn't inside the swag. How's your swag, Alex?
Hey, bone dry. Two pillows.
Oh, have a go at the setup. God, I hope you can see some. Passes the torch.
I've tied off to a fishing rod.
All right, so there's Alex's swag up the front of the 490. I got the crash pad down here. So my crash pad's dry, but I had the pillow on the outside, so it's mouldy. And the boys, big Timmy's up the front. He's living in luxury up there, Timmy, aren't you?
No, I'm not actually.
He's got food at his disposal.
Why did you bring so much shit in the boat, Timmy? Oh, and then Justin there, he's rolling another swag out on the back. How's your pillow?
Yeah, she's wet, mate.
She's wet. Oh, the swag's dry on the inside. And then my sleeping bag was on the outside, so it's wet as well, so I'm using that as a pillow. All right, see you in the morning.
No
noise. No noise.
Swag life.
All right, boys, come on. Time to get up, waggy waggy.
What was that?
Nice fish rag for you, mate. Oh. Get you in the motivation for the day.
Fish rag? Must have come from their boat. They didn't catch any fish.
How's the view?
We're not five-star, mate. We're a million-star here. That's, mate, under the skies. Beautiful, mate.
Honestly, the stars came out last night. I just slept with this just laid over the top of me. Million star view, slept like a log.
Great view to wake up to too.
Oh, happy days.
Gotta be happy with that.
That's absolutely killer. Look at that. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a bloody cracker.
That's large. Got a little pilly head. Dick. It's cool. Almost as bloody size of a snapper.
Cool lunch before breakfast. Justin the Brim Whisperer seems to keep catching it. Me and Alex can't catch a bloody thing. So we're going to just throw the wetty on because it's a little bit chilly. Jump in, we're just going to float along through all this fallen trees in the water here, see if we can't spear something for lunch. Oh, speaking of Brim Whisperers, he nearly got another one. Let's go.
Hey!
Well, no need to go diving anymore, that'll do me.
Day two at Withumba, day two on the boats, that is. We camped here last night, and first for me, swagger in the back of a boat. It was bloody nice, actually. Just rocks you to sleep gently, you know. Coffee this morning, first thing. I can't function without coffee, so we've knocked one up on the back of the boat while the lads have gone for a spearfish. And I'm quietly hoping that we catch more here than they do. So here's hoping, because they're pretty chuffed that they reckon they're gonna spear a mangrove jack or a barracuda or something flash like that. So we'll just keep sitting here. We might catch a few brim. Me and Timmy have a coffee, and then we're gonna set the barbecue up on the beach. And we'll have bacon and eggs for brekkie.
All right, well, it does not get any better than this. Pretty much slice of paradise here. We've been for a morning spear, got to swim the turtle this morning, which pretty much made my morning already. Alex is just coming out now. I think he's got a couple more brim, so that'll be lunch. Bacon and eggs are on the go this morning. Have a look at the colour of the water. Happy days. Gourmet brekkie in paradise.
Alright, we landed this tuna yesterday, so we think it's a long tail, not 100% sure. Let us know in the comments, but gonna fill it up now. Get some steaks out of it and hopefully have some tonight.
Alright, well, how good's this? Absolute glass. Glass. We're straight out of the Thumber Creek. We've just got three lines in, a couple of stick baits and a bit of a diver. So we got them trawling out the back. One hell of a day. It's a bit of a change from yesterday.
Mate, oh, we've got a little bombing bait ball right here.
Perfect. So at the moment we're in about 10 metres of water. We're going to push right out to probably the 20s today.
Oh, it's a Jenny anyway.
Jenny.
I'm too small.
Righto, so we've had no luck with the bloody crab pots. One of them's been destroyed by a shark, and another one has been share farmed by another fisherman, we reckon. So we've got nothing but one little Jenny and a little fish, so we're just going to move them sort of a K up the beach, find a little drop off with some weed, and we rebait them with a bit of tuna. So hopefully we get some crabs, but my tip is that we'll probably get another couple of destroyed pots by sharks, because we've got the nice, delicious tuna head sitting in the bottom of it.
What happened, mate?
I'm the worst fisherman.
I honestly don't know. I must have just pulled it down a little bit too tight. That's the second one of these f***ing carbon fibre.
Got the money there. Oh, I'm right into it. Oh yeah, oh, he had a hit. Go, go.
Oh, Jesus, right in, mate. Get him in. They're everywhere.
I need you to get rid of that rod. I don't know what it is.
Big school of tuna around us.
It's not massive, but he's good size. Here comes the leader.
Here we go. Oh, that's a good. Oh, he's foul hooked him. Keep that pressure on. Watch that pressure. Let him run.
Get ready.
Baby! That's a dunker!
Yes! On the foul hook! Oh, we got one! Oh, happy days, about bloody time! Yes!
Alright, you're on your own, I'm
getting one.
Oh, get back in there.
Hey. We're on again, big boy!
We're on!
Get her in! We need another one for the boat!
Okay, he's swimming with me.
I just tried to cast mine. You're gonna have to tighten that drag up and flush it.
Oh,
yeah. I just lost my lure. So I'm trying to rig a rod back up. We're surrounded by these bastards.
They're
finally
everywhere.
Alex is back on.
Oh, yeah, Brick.
You've got this, big boy.
Yeah! Son of a stalker!
Woo!
Beauty!
Dude, this is
heavy. You guys planning on catching fish anytime soon?
What'd you get? Three.
Time for a cold beer and we're gonna cook up a couple of. What do we got? Brim.
Brim.
Bit of brim for lunch.
Flatty.
Bit of flatty.
Primary.
Happy days.
Pretty safe to say I'm still probably the best fisherman out here.
Alright, so we've just chopped up, filleted a heap of brim, a couple of little whiting and a little codley.
So then we're just gonna get the old lightly seasoning coating mix. Just simple. Get the barbie nice and hot, a little bit of oil on there, and we'll just give them a quick touch up. How's this for a bit of lunch? Yeah, the boys. There we go, it's bloody hard to beat. Fresh fish, bit of mayo, cheese, lettuce, in a wrap, out on the boat, in the rain. How good's living?
Go. We're back on. Oh, I need to get back on another one. There's a big bust up straight up there. Well, another cracking day out on the water. Three more dogs.
That's it.
I'm gonna fill these up, have a couple of beers, anchor back up like we did last night. It's not looking good. Looks like it's gonna pour rain again, but we'll roll the swags out in the boat and hopefully tomorrow we get a sunny day.
That time, we deserve it.
We definitely deserve a sunny day.
Righto, that's the end of day two on the boats, but just before we go to bed, I'm gonna have to show you something pretty funny. So, hey lads, where's your heads? Hey, what's going on, Avery?
This is stupid.
Ah, come to Fraser, he said. You're in the 6:30. I said, no, yeah, no dramas about that. Look at this, hey? We've adapted a bit of a safety device, and we're high and dry over here, mate. Alex and Maddie, well, I don't know.
Oh my god. So it looks like I was cozy, but we didn't have poles up initially. It poured with rain, so the whole inside of my swag is full of water. I didn't know I could fit the poles. Alex is full of water, soaking wet. That was a shocking night.
Oh, everything's wet.
Hopefully we get some sunshine soon so we're not all so bloody miserable and cold. I'm gonna start making our way back.
It sounds rough out there.
And it sounds really rough and windy. Game on.
We're a little bit scared.
Yep.
A little bit scared. It sounds rough as hell out there. And we are going to get extremely wet, I think. As long as the rain stays away, that'll be one improvement.
It will, but it's still not going to be enjoyable.
Stay tuned. It's going to be a hell of a run home.
All right, well, there you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Something a little bit different for the Explore crew. A little bit of Explore offshore. If you did enjoy it, let us know in the comments. Make sure you chuck us a like, subscribe. Till next time, get out and enjoy the Explore Life.